Hello everyone, Derek's Damn Toys back with a, I guess you could say, just a little bit of an update video. As you can tell, my arena is quite a mess, and that's because I'm starting to round up the third episode of Damn Defiant Wrestling, my little pick fed show. I'm just still trying to decide how I'm going to take it from here on out, because I don't want my episodes to keep on getting blocked and stuff like that, so I don't know. I wouldn't mind trying to do the commentary style, but that's not what this video is about. As you can see, I've got a couple of figures lined up in the ring. One is a custom, the rest of them are just kind of more or less fix-ups. And if you can't tell which one's a custom and which ones aren't, I will gladly explain. But just to kind of get into things first and foremost, I just recently had a tooth extraction done. That's why I'm talking a little bit weird. I probably shouldn't even really be bothering to make a video at the moment, but so far, it's been pretty decent. I feel a hell of a lot better now that I got the tooth extracted compared to when it was in my mouth. I'm not going to go into very big detail, but let's just say I was dealing with tooth pain. It was cheaper for me to just get the tooth ripped out than it would be to do a bunch of extra stuff and get like a root canal or something, so I just decided to do that, and it's been a hell of a lot better the past 3 days, but hopefully that'll clear up and I can get a move on with my life and try to finish up episode 3 of Damn Defiant Wrestling. But speaking of episode 3, obviously none of these figures were featured in episode 3. He still might, but I digress on that because it probably will be more of a 4th or 5th episode thing when you see that little Cody fix-up, which, getting into that, if you didn't watch episode 2, you wouldn't know Cody is my inaugural World Heavyweight Champion. He won the Damn Defiant Wrestling Tournament. So I made a suit, a suit figure of him, because obviously I don't have the, Unrivaled Series 4 Cody Rhodes. So I don't just have a casual suit Cody to use in the pick fed, so I took the John Laurinaitis Build-A-Figure, replaced the head sculpt, and if I really want to, I'll pop the head sculpt back on and keep it as a John Laurinaitis, but for pick fed purposes, that might stay around for a little bit. Now this old Christian figure of mine, as you can tell, it's a little beat up, it's old, it's been around the block for a minute, but I actually gave this Christian interchangeable hands, so now if I want to, I can actually do proper entrance poses and stuff like that, like have the flat hand as he does his little searching for the peeps or whatever thing, and I just feel like that helps it better in the long run for the pick fed as well, because then I can do his slaps and stuff like that and they'll look a little bit more accurate, because I want to try to make sure I do the interchangeable hands during the match as much as I can, just to make the matches look a little better. Sorry for that little adjustment in the camera, I was rolling up my sleeve. Now getting into this one, as you can see, I put knee pads onto the CM Punk, and I put one of the Mattel head sculpts onto this unrivaled CM Punk. Maybe not the best as far as like skin tone and stuff goes. I don't think the skin tone is completely inaccurate to how AEW's got it. Of course, the head sculpt's a little bit beat up though, as you can see in the hairline, but maybe one of these days I'll fix that back up and make it look a little better. As far as the knee pads go, it just makes me feel a little bit better if I have the knee pads on. Not that it's completely 100% accurate, but them kick pads are just a little too tiny. So having the knee pads bulking out a little bit kind of makes it look a little bit more normal. Maybe it's just me though. I've been thinking about using smaller knee pads though, because sometimes these will drape down to the kick pad area, and it's just a little pain in the ass. But now getting into what I would say is the main event, the custom figure. As you guys can tell, I put the Elite Fiend torso onto this Bray Wyatt lower half. And the boots are technically different, but I had that on the figure anyways. And I put the Firefly Funhouse Bray Wyatt head sculpt on it, and I think it looks really cool. Of course, the back of the neck isn't as accurate as it could be with the rest of the body, because that part is way darker compared to the neck, or, well, the skull portion of it. If you couldn't see, just a little bit more of a zoom in on it. But I figured, because I probably won't use the Firefly Funhouse version of Bray Wyatt in the pick fed, I kind of wanted one that looks a little bit more modern day and or just a little bit more accurate to how he comes out now. And this is probably the best I could get it. Now, I did take a little bit of inspiration on the Bray Wyatt from another YouTuber whose name is Wrestling Hero Figs, who kind of did something similar, but instead of cracking the torso, he just swapped the lower legs onto the Fiend body. And if I'm going to be honest, it was probably the better alternative, because this torso, as good as the ab crunches, the arms were extremely loose. I actually had to put tiny little rubber bands and stuff like that in between the arms, so then the arms could hold a bit more of a pose, and even then they're still a little loose. So I gotta put a little bit more work into that before he's fully poseable for pick fed purposes. But honestly, all around, I don't regret it. The only thing I do regret with that figure is that I couldn't take the old torso, put it onto the Fiend legs, and like make a completely custom Bray Wyatt out of it. But at least I got the main custom, so I'll still be having a little bit of fun with it. But yeah, but before I continue rambling on, I did get a good chunk of episode 3 done. I do still technically have a little bit more left to film. And then I gotta figure out, do I plan on trying to use maybe like copyright free music, or do I want to try to commentate it? Because I know if I do commentary, it won't be as good as everybody else's, because I don't know if I have the proper app to like add in all the little like sound effects and stuff like that, like them hitting the apron or the middle of the mat, or creating sound effects for the chairs and stuff like that. Maybe I'll do like a little mixture of both, where I kind of have like some copyright free music in the background, but you'll still hear me commentating. Because after this episode is done, I don't know if I want to keep doing long episodes like I have been, especially for them to just get taken down, because the music I used was not protected under fair use. Just because my full intention, as much as I would love to make money from the pig fed, I know I'm not going to make money from the pig fed. A lot of time and effort goes into that to where it wouldn't be as profitable as making like some of the other smaller videos that I do, like trying figure reviews and maybe doing stuff like this where I show you guys customs and stuff. But I don't know, maybe that's just me. But on that note, I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. Like the video if you liked it, dislike it if you dislike it, I don't really care, it don't hurt my feelings at the end of the day. But if you could, I would love it if you would subscribe. If not, it's cool beans though. But top of that, if you guys have any social media like Instagram and Twitter, I do have those, and I also do have a TikTok. I haven't been posting on it as recently because of the whole toothache and stuff of that nature. But, hey, you know, I'm trying to make a little small video for you guys while I'm in recovery, and hopefully I can get back to doing more videos like this. And if not exactly like this, I want to maybe make like random little figure matches, like dream matches that I personally have. And maybe I could commentate over those, and they won't have like direct canon to my pig fed, but it'll give me something to do in the spare time that I'm not working on the pig fed, because if I told you I worked on the pig fed every day, I'd be lying to not just you, but to myself. Anyways, on that note, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Peace, y'all.